Lockheed Martin announced that it's delivered Helios, or High Energy Laser, with integrated optical dazzler and surveillance to the U.S. Navy. The long-awaited seaborne defensive laser weapon system will be tested by the U.S. Navy this year. As per reports, the 60-kilowatt Helios will be integrated into a guided missile destroyer assigned to the Pacific Fleet. It follows a 2019 demonstration of laser weapon capability aboard the amphibious transport dock USS Ponce. Importantly, the power of the latest system is twice that of the earlier one. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the 60-kilowatt Helios will change naval warfare. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. Laser is one of these systems being developed to meet emerging threats. The Congressional Research Service said in a report that the U.S. Navy is developing 3 new ship-based weapons: lasers, an electromagnetic railgun, and a gun-launched guided projectile. As per the report, these weapons could substantially improve the ability of surface ships to defend against small surface craft, unmanned aerial vehicles, and eventually anti-ship cruise missiles. The report states, "Any one of these new weapons, if successfully developed and deployed, might be regarded as a game changer for defending Navy surface ships against enemy missiles." The research service noted that the U.S. Navy has made substantial progress toward deploying lasers on ships. Viewers may note that the U.S. Navy has awarded Lockheed Martin a $150 million contract in 2018 with options worth up to $943 million for the development of high-power laser systems. The program aims to develop 2 prototypes, one for land and another for destroyers. As per Lockheed Martin, with the Helios system, it will help the Navy take a major step forward in its goal to field a laser weapon system aboard surface ships. The Helios effort is focused on rapidly developing and deploying a 60-kilowatt high-energy laser with growth potential to 150 kilowatts. Essentially, laser beam weaponry hits a target with a train of brief pulses of light. The rapid evaporation and expansion of the surface causes shock waves that damage the target. Lockheed Martin had earlier stated that it demonstrated that a 10-kilowatt system can defeat small airborne targets with the speed of light capability, and that a 30-kilowatt system had disabled a stationary truck target. Helios has an expandable design. According to Lockheed officials, the scalable laser design architecture combines multiple kilowatt fiber lasers to attain high beam quality at various power levels. Helios will be integrated with U.S. Navy's Aegis combat systems. The system will have multiple usages, as the full name suggests. Helios was primarily designed as a weapon capable of taking out small missile boats, which are being deployed by some rival as part of an asymmetric counter against U.S. Navy. Helios will be effective against drone swarms, too. It can also be used to merely dazzle a UAV's electro-optical sensors. This could damage the sensor and prevent a UAV from navigating, ultimately disabling it. Helios has a long-range intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance capability. Though Lockheed Martin hasn't revealed the details, indications are that the aiming system of Helios is capable of high-definition, high-powered digital magnification. This will allow the crew of the ship, which has the system installed to properly inspect the threats in its vicinity. Laser systems like Helios have several very important advantages. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. With further development, lasers can be used to save costly defensive missiles for the most sophisticated threats. Where a laser weapon like Helios is particularly compelling is its ability to fire a theoretically unlimited number of shots using the destroyer's onboard electrical generation systems. This is not the case with current defensive weapons. Phalanx, close-in weapon system, is limited to 20 to 30 seconds of continuous firing, while rolling airframe missile, or RAM, is limited to 21 missiles aboard the Mark 49 guided missile launching system. But everything's not cozy. There are challenges too. The most basic is that the power source in the warship will have to be scaled up, as additional power will be required for the functioning of the lasers. Small missile boats, or fast-moving crafts laden with explosives, are a potential challenge to the U.S. Navy. While the threat that small boats pose to major warships has been apparent for some time, the Pentagon's Millennium Challenge 2002 exercise brought the issue to mainstream attention. In that controversial exercise, small fast boats carrying suicide payloads inflicted heavy damage on U.S. naval forces. This kind of craft lacks the range to find and successfully attack aircraft carriers or warships in the open sea, but can be deadly in certain constrained spaces like the Strait of Hormuz. Also, drones are no longer just being used as harmless hobby systems. These are being employed as weapons to strike targets at long standoff ranges. Drone technology has become very advanced and relatively cheap. The conflicts in Iraq and Syria have shown that this kind of capability is within reach of even non-state actors. In January 2018, a mass drone attack was witnessed on Russia's main outposts in Syria, the Kemenin Air Base and Naval Base in Tartus. Though the damage from the attack was insignificant, as per Russia, it clearly displayed the potential of drones in warfare. On September 14, 2019, the facilities of Saudi Arabia's oil company Aramco, located in the east of the country, came under attack. As per reports, the raid began around 4 a.m., and 18 drones, as well as 7 cruise missiles, were used. These were able to penetrate hard-kill interceptor-based air defense, including American-made Patriot. It remains to be seen how the latest variant of Helios works, but the move is certainly in the right direction. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.